change jumping jacks. Change splits. Head press in. Butt kicks. I mean, lats, walk,
hello everyone, welcome to the session. So how is it going? We did a session 2 weeks back. How's the practice going with it? Have you all been practicing on that? Can you all hear me?
Yes, we can.
Yes, great. Okay. So how is the practice going? I think we have a lot of new members this time.
Yeah, I can see a lot of new members.
Okay, please keep your mics on mute. We'll be communicating more through hand gestures. And yes, if you have any questions, you can always put it in the question section, which we'll answer at the end of the session. Right. Okay. So now that we have completed a warm up, thank you, Deepak, for the warm up. So we'll be doing this session in continuation to our last session that we did, where we focused more on certain poses, certain positions to help you get to the next level of your fitness. Right. And this session is only for people who are looking to do this. And it's not like, you know, if you're a beginner, so you cannot do this, or if you have been doing this for a long time, and if you find it difficult, so you cannot do this, or if you have a back or a neck issue, so you cannot do this, because we are taking all the precautions. We are treating you as a newcomer itself. We are starting everything from scratch. So no worries on that. Is that clear to everyone? Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. So let me just, I'll have to keep looking. I hope you cannot hear any echo. A lot of people today. Awesome. All right. I'll request everyone to please mute your mic and switch on your cameras. I can see you all. Right. So with the warm up, let's do a little bit of wrist mobility. Like I told you last time, wrist mobility is something that we need in order to improve our position in all the poses that we will be doing. Wrist mobility is of extreme importance.
Dr. Sudarshan, one request, anything for tendonitis patient not to be done, just specifically mention.
What is your symptom or problem?
Do you have any pain?
Mild one now.
In fact, the stretches will help. No worries. Just move it both sides. Up and down like this. I'm going to go very slow for this session. Okay. It's more like a review of what we did last time and just to cross check about how are you doing overall. Okay. So let me just position my mat so that you can see me properly. I hope you can hear me. So that's not a problem, right? Okay. All right. So this is the position. Now I want you to start up with a little bit of what we call the scapular push-ups. Okay. So your hand position is on 1/4 of the mat. Right? Your hand position is 1/4 of the mat. Take your legs backward. You're not putting weight on your toes. You're rather taking your toes in the backward side, okay? And then shifting all your weight on your upper body. All your weight on your upper body, like this. Can we try this? I want to see everybody's position. So just make sure you fit in your camera accordingly so that I can see you all. Right. Can we do that?
Yes.
Toes backward. Okay. Weight on your hands
and shift your body forward.
Come on. Shift your body forward. Yeah. Come on.
Awesome. We are not doing any push-ups right now. I just want you to hold
that position for 30 seconds.
That's it.
Just hold that position for 30 seconds. Firm.
Your wrists, your hands are
absolutely firm. Your fingers can be bending a little bit so that you have multiple pressure areas or pressure points. Yeah.
Awesome.
Very good. Superb.
Nice. Awesome.
Right. Now we modify this position a bit. Once again, 1/4 of the mat. Toes backwards. Body weight forward. And what you need to do is just move your scapular area up and down. Up and down, up and down. We can do 10 counts of this. Come on. If you find difficulty in keeping your weight off the toes, you can actually put it on the toes. That's fine.
Since you're beginning, it's absolutely okay. Awesome. Only movement is from the scapula, the shoulder portion.
You're not even bending your elbow. Just taking your scapula up and up. We need 10 counts. We need to do 10 counts. In all this position,
as you keep doing exercise, if you feel a little bit of stiffness around the wrist, keep moving it. Keep stretching it. Right? The more you stretch it, the more you will be able to make it mobile.
So keep stretching it. Thanks. Okay, so how many of you have the handle that I had asked you to get it? Any of you have handles? Handles that we discussed last time?
Like this?
These ones? Any of you? I understand it is difficult to procure at this point of time. So even if you couldn't get it, it's fine. You can probably try and practice without the handle. Okay. So let's start our next pose. I want you to start up with push-ups now. We did a scapular push-up now. So what we'll do is again, get back to your 1/4 position on the mat. Your hands are exactly at 1/4 area of the mat. Toes can be this way. If you're not very comfortable, you can keep your toes in this manner. Otherwise, take it backwards so that you can engage your core more and shift your body weight forwards. And if you see the position of the wrist, it is more towards the front of the body, more towards above my chest area. Okay. It's not straight. It's not like this. It's going forward. So this is what the position that I ideally would seek. Okay. People who have not been able to do complete push-ups can actually support their knees also. You can actually do it in this position also. It's absolutely fine. But just shift your body weight forward in this manner. Okay? You can support it on your knees if you have not been doing regular push-ups. For others who have been doing regular push-ups, come up, shift your body weight. And now, as you bend your knee, go down very slowly and come up like this. So you touch your pelvis to the mat. 2. Try and do this very slowly. I'm not expecting you to do this completely and absolutely perfect, but I want you to try. Now, one important thing here is that when you're moving your shoulders, a lot of people will actually move your shoulders outside. So don't do that. Keep your shoulders, it's on the edge of the mat. And if you look at me, when I'm going down, all it's happening is the shoulder is exactly falling in line with the body. And then coming up. A lot of you will do this because it will be easy. I don't want you to do that. Okay? It is okay if you cannot do 10 counts, but the position has to be correct, like this, because that's where you're keeping maximum pressure on your biceps area and doing it well. Okay, so I'm checking your positions now.
Yes.
Elbows bend. Nice. Good, Sriyari.
Good, Milan.
Come on, Ashwini.
Come on, Poonam. Come on, Kailash.
Good, Himanshu. Good, Lakshman. Good, Babu.
Good, Mr. Come on, Sunil.
Yes, I want to keep checking your positions. So do it slowly. It's absolutely okay. You can do it slowly.
And if you want me to check your positions, just raise your hand or give me a voice.
So we do 10 counts of this.
Okay. 10 counts. And once you're free, just keep moving your wrist a little bit. Give it a little bit of relaxation
and mobility, because every time you do this movement, you're actually extending your wrist beyond your normal position. And this is not a very regular feature that you do.
So
keep relaxing your wrists.
Keep taking it in this direction. Right?
Nice.
Okay.
Is everyone on the same page with me? Is everyone doing well?
Great.
Okay. So now
let's come to the next position.
So the next position is where I want you to sit on your knees. Okay, if you have difficulty or if you have knee pain, we can modify that position. And try to simply sit in this manner. What you have to do is get your weights, get your hands on the sides. Yeah. And legs close and try to put all your body weight on the hands and try to get off the floor. Try and get off the floor like this. Try to get off the floor. Try to put all your weight on your hands and try to get off the floor. Come on. Try. Just make sure you don't fall. If you have a handle, by the way, any of you guys, if, in case you have a handle, use the handle. Okay, you can use the handle and come up like this.
Okay. Can we sit in Padmasana pose?
You can try. Yes, yes. Not a problem. You can do that.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. You can even sit in Padmasana, hands on the sides and come up like this. Right? Come on. I want you to try this for about 30 to 40 seconds. See, all you have to do is put weight on it, get off the floor. If you can sustain that position, good enough. If you cannot, just go down slowly. And then try it again. All you have to do is put weight on your hands, come up, and slowly go down. Awesome. And you should start working on this time, okay? You should try and see how much seconds you're able to hold onto your hands. Okay? Is everyone able to do this? Can everyone
palms
do
are
this?
Stretching.
Sorry? No? Yes, palms are absolutely stretching. Yes, yes, yes. And you should always try to keep your fingers folded. So when you're keeping your fingers folded, it is not straight like this. It is folded, a little bit folded. What happens when it is folded is you create multiple pressure points. You don't just have one pressure point on your wrist, but you have multiple pressure points which are on your wrist, which is on your fingers, which is on different areas. So try to keep your fingers bent like this, bent. The more you bend your fingers, you create more pressure points.
I'm not able to lift myself while palms are touching to the floor.
Yes, it's okay. It is a practice. So you need
to keep practicing this. Okay. We are not going to get this in first go. Possible. It is absolutely okay. No problem. So one thing what you can do is that if you're not able to lift it, maybe just try to use a little bit of books around this area. You know, you can keep two books on both sides. Thick, good amount, good thick books. Okay. So if you keep books around this side, what happens is that you're just increasing your height here, and then it becomes easier for you to put your weight on your hands and then come up like this. Okay. That is also possible. How many of you can try that? If you've not been able to get this position, try. You can use stacks of papers, newspapers, or even a good thick book. Both sides, you can even have, if you have yoga blocks, you can also use the yoga blocks. They're also awesome thing which you can do. Keep it on the sides, weight, and raise. Come on, try. If you're not very, very happy with this position, you can try this modification. Yes. Now see if you can do it. Nice.
Good.
Raise it up. Try. See, I'm going to do a very slow and easy session with you because my objective is to make sure that you're able to at least get 2 to 3 poses, okay, which are relatively not at all easy. They are difficult. So we are going to take time. This is not a high intensity training program, but yes, the calories what you're burning is equally good. Okay, so don't worry about that. Stay with me. And you will enjoy this. By the end of the session, when you're able to do this independently, it will give you a great feeling. Okay, so come on, try. Books on the sides, put your weight on it and come out like this. So now when you're able to do this, now what I want you to do this, you went in a Padmasana position. And some of you try to get into this position, right? Where your knees are close to your chest, right? Now, what I want you to do is, as you're putting weight on your hands like this, try to straighten up your knees, okay? So when you're straightening up your knees, certainly the weight is on the hands only, okay? All you have to do is try to straighten up your knees. Now, that is the position what we call L sit. That position is called L sit. Okay. So what I want you to do is, whether you are in Padmasana or if you are close with the knee, all you have to do is straighten up your knee. Come on. Try. Come on. Okay. This is not going to happen on a bed. Okay. You have to do this on the floor. It will not happen on a bed because you will never get the support that you need to push your whole body weight on the bed. So don't try it on a bed. Don't try it on a sofa. You need a floor. You need a hard surface where you can do this. Right. How is it going? Come on, come on. I want you to hold it for at least 5 to 10 seconds. Come on. You have to try this.
Yeah, doctor, 1 second. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. While trying to hold this, I'm not able to hold at all.
You are able to lift it off the floor, right? So this is the beginning. No worries. So this is where, since you're able to hold, lift it off the floor, eventually you will take more time. So that's absolutely okay. You have to keep trying on it. What I suggest is, Srirang, you can try and use two books. Okay. Keep two books on the sides and then try to lift. You'll find it relatively easier. So what happens is that whenever you use a book or when you use a height like this, you're actually, trying to work more on the stability. Because you get a good stability, it becomes easy for you to raise it up like this. Okay, so because of this height and probably because also of the wrist position, so try using a book. Keep increase the height over there, and then try to shift. Have you guys seen results after using the book? How many of you have been able to do that? A thumbs up. Good, good. Have you been able to do that?
Doctor, I'm able to do that only in the Padmasana position.
You can try. See, now that is a question of flexibility. See, the reason you're able to do this in Padmasana because your hips are not so flexible. So you need to work on that flexibility. We will work on that too. But yes, since you can do that in Padmasana, eventually you can try to straighten up your knees and you can practice in the same position. Try to hold it for longer seconds. So once you get your hip flexibility, you will be able to do it with the knee extended. Okay. So can we move on to the next pose now? Or
Doctor,
do you want to? Yes.
If this is beginner, what is pro?
Pro is when you're able to do an L sit, move it and go back like this. Okay. So that's pro, which we will do eventually. Okay, right. So now, next position is, if you remember, we did some exercises with chair support. Okay, nice, nice. good practice. I think Manish is doing good. Yes. Who else can I see? Okay. I think rest of them, you all are relaxing. Okay. So let's move on to the next one. Okay. Now, what I want you to do is I want you to try and attempt 5 push-ups. What we did initially was a planche push-ups, okay, where we had our mat on 1/4 of the mat, okay, and then we had a mat of 1/4 of the mat, and then the toes were backwards, and then when we went down like this with the pelvis completely down. Now, what I want you to do is that take your legs forward like this. See to what extent can you take your legs forward, okay? The lesser distance between your hands and the legs, the better it is, the more difficult it is. Okay. So I don't want you to start off immediately with this. Just see where you're comfortable. Okay. Take your legs closer to your hands and then slowly move your head forward and up. Go down and up. Now, this is another exercise to improve your weight bearing on the shoulders, to improve your core training. Okay. So how many of you can do that? Come on, let's do this. First, I want you to take position. Don't immediately start the exercise. Take position. Feel your weight on your hands. Feel the pike that you can make. Okay. It should not be just a flat one. It should be a pike. You should be able to actually, in Srihari, you have a good position. Sunil, keep your knees straight. Vivek, you're doing well. Yes. Now that when you have your weights on your hands, now when you can feel your body weight, now start moving your elbows and start moving your head forward with your elbows bent. Awesome. And take it up. Very good. Super. Very nice. Srihari doing well. Sunil doing well. So there is one mistake what you could do is bend your elbows and take your head backwards. Don't do that. You need to keep your head forward. The weight has to be pushed forward. It will not go backwards. Please understand. Come on. And make sure you maintain that pike. You know, your body goes with that pike. Okay. For all the people who want me to see their form, we need to have a side view, okay? Because I will not be able to see your form in the front view. Side view. Side view will help. Yes. Manish is doing good. Manish, you need to... Yes, good. Manish, position is good. Come on, Anupam. Yes. Bend your elbows. See, you have to focus on your head. Okay. All you have to focus is shifting your head forward and moving your elbows. These are only the two movements that are going to happen. Rest, everything moves with the flow. So try and work it that way. Come on. Awesome. Elbows are coming forward. You want to see the position once again? Just check this. So my hands are here, 1/4 of the mat, legs are forward on toes. If you cannot do it, if you cannot keep it on, it should be ideally on toes and you keep moving forward. Okay. Now bend your elbows and take your head forward. Try and touch it to the mat if possible, or just go a little down. Now you see the movement is only from the head and the elbows. Rest of the body is moving like a unit. This is what we want. Come on. Can we do 10 counts of this? Nice. Good, Chandrakant. Move your elbows forward. Good. Good. Okay. How many of you are able to do this? Good. How many of you are not able to do this at all? Anyone? Himanshu, you're not able to do it at all. What is the difficulty?
I won't be able to move down. When I'm trying to move down, it's getting pain on wrist.
That's okay. So it's basically this flexibility, but you can practice this. Okay. So see, what we are going to do is that, like, you know, we do this session once in 2 weeks with me, and the rest of the week, when we are doing the regular workouts, we will also build in these things. Like the trainers will ask you to do pike push-ups. The trainers will ask you to do pseudo planche push-ups. So this is like a practice for you. Instead of your regular push-ups, you will try and modify it to do this kind of push-ups. Okay. So when you are doing these Saturday classes on a regular basis, that's where you will build up and you will keep practicing this in your regular online sessions also. Okay. You get that, all of you? Yeah. Okay. So I'm giving you a 1 minute break now. Just take a break, have some water. Relax yourself.
Sudarshan sir, please help me with some wrist-related flexibility exercise later on, na, for the tendonitis.
Sure.
I'm unable to do most of them. It's painful.
So, yes, I understand. So a lot of people who will have wrist flexibility issues, you will have a little bit of pain when you're trying to attempt this. This is absolutely normal. So all I will suggest is a lot of mobility that you can keep doing, stretches, okay, and do some icing to the area so that you can recover. Okay, this is all what we have to do. If you have TheraBands at home, okay, you can also do some TheraBand exercises where we do these resistance exercises with TheraBand. So you can also try and do that. Wrist movements only. So this will actually help to strengthen your wrist. See, basically the weight bearing itself is going to strengthen your wrist a lot. At this point of time, all you need is flexibility. I understand that you don't have this kind of flexibility, but the more you practice this, you will eventually see that, you know, your flexibility is improving. So all you have to do is stretches in this manner and moving your wrist in all directions like this. Anupam, don't worry about the strength in your arms. Eventually, see, that's why I told you, even the holding position, all the position that we do while holding, that itself is equally effective for you, and it will help you to actually kind of build your tone for your shoulders and your arms. So it is a process. It will happen. All I want you to do is give 100% in your online trainings also, which happens on a regular basis. Ensure that you're attending them regularly and ensure that, you know, you are doing this on a regular basis. So once you do that, you will see that the tone is definitely improving a lot. Okay. I'm going to focus a lot on your flexibility also today, because I feel that is one of the most important thing, which will always be a hurdle whenever we are trying to do these kind of activities. Okay. So we'll be focusing a lot on your flexibility. Okay, guys, are you all ready now? Yep. I think most of you are there back. Right. So what all we did today? We did wrist mobility. We did scapular push-ups. We did pseudo planche push-ups. We did spike push-ups. Okay. And then we also tried the L-sit position. The putting weight on your hands and then trying to do the L-sit, which was well attempted by all of you. So now let's move on to the next exercise. Okay. So last time, if you remember, we did the crow pose, right? So how many of you have been working on it, and how many of you have been able to achieve that? Can we go through it once again and try and do it. Yeah. Hello, people. Yeah. Okay. So you can probably make your mat double, okay? Because you will need more weight bearing, okay? Now, hands are at a shoulder width apart. I don't want you to do this. I just want you to see it right now, okay? Hands are a shoulder width apart. Now, you keep your knees in this position. And just your knees are just above the elbow. This is the position that we need. Now, in this position, try to shift your weight off the toes. Okay. Let's say we try it for one leg like this, then the other. Let's say we do it for the right leg and then the other. Now you can try this with me. Okay. Can you try this? Come on. Come to this position. Hands are shoulder width apart. Right? Get your legs closer, feet firm first, then position your knees just above your elbows and try to shift your body weight. Try to shift your body weight like this, more on your hands. Don't flip. Don't flip on the other side. Easy. Take it easy. And then shift weight from the right side, then from the left side. At any point of time, if you feel confident, you can even try this there. You can just take that weight off for a second and then again come back like this. Back, up, back.
And there is a bend to the elbow, right?
Yes, there is a bend to the elbow in the beginning. Yes, absolutely. You should bend your elbow because that will give you a support that you need to hold on to your knees. Make sure you block your knees with your elbow and make it a support system here. So as long as the support is not available, if your knees falling off like this, if it is going off like this, you will not get the support. So if there is any sweat, if you have any sweat around the knee area, if you have any sweat around the elbow area, clear that off, okay? Because you will tend to slip. You will constantly keep slipping because of that, okay? And then hands firm, legs here and slowly up. For all the people who can do it, take this position. Come on and try and hold it. For all the people who can take the position, get into the position and hold it. Check your time. For all the people who find it a little difficult, let me know what is blocking you. Very good, Manish. Awesome. Abhishek, your position of hands is wrong. Ashwini Shinde, sorry. Ashwini, your hand position is very close. I said your hands have to be shoulder width apart. You know, see, if you have a good distance between your hands, that will create a strong base of support. If you have your hands closer like this, that is not good. It has to be at least shoulder width apart. Okay. And it is not in this position. It is in this position. Firm. Again, as I told you, whenever we are keeping weight on the fingers, they have to be bent. They have to be bent. They don't have to be absolutely straight. If they are completely straight, you'll put weight only on the wrist. When the knees are, when the fingers are bending, you will put weight on the wrist. You will put weight on the certain areas of your fingers. Okay. So that will create additional pressure points. So all the people who have been able to achieve the position, I want you to practice.
Doctor.
Yes.
My own weight is blocking me. What to do?
Whom am I talking to? I can't hear you.
Ravindra, Ashtekar.
That's okay. That is absolutely fine. Tell me, till where are you achieving? What are you achieving exactly till now?
You can watch me.
Yeah, sure. Pretty good.
Doctor.
Yes.
With this thing, there is a pain out here because, you know, I think you're hurting your hand. Yes. With the
knee. See, where exactly do you feel the pain? Look, if you are putting your weight around this area, this is the right area where you should put your weight. You should not be putting your weight on the elbow joint. Okay. It is, I told you, it is above the elbow joint on your triceps area. Okay. So make sure you put or support your knee on the triceps area. Ravindra, you're doing pretty well actually. So attempting this for the first time, let me tell you, this is one of the most difficult poses of yoga. Okay. Which I'm simply trying to break it off for you. Amazing. So which I'm simply trying to break it off for you and give you in parts and helping you achieve this simply in one session. So understand that it is a difficult pose and you guys are doing it pretty well. Yes. Anyone who's not been able to get it and wants to discuss. Guys, I don't want you to sit. Everyone will keep practicing. I want to see your positions. Come on. Keep practicing.
Doctor, good. How is going to be the pressure?
Who's this?
Monica.
Monica. Yes. Yeah.
But you're attempting that position. How is going to be the pressure? Not able to hold it.
Knee and?
Hi.
Pressure, matlab kaise? In what way do you feel the pressure?
Yeah, I'll try. Attempt the position.
Yes, and tell me. Yes, absolutely. So see, what I want you to do is that, one mistake that we normally do is that you try to take both the legs off,
okay,
and try to achieve the pose completely. I want you to go step by step. If you see what I have done is keep your hands firm. Okay. Do not take your leg immediately off the floor. First, take position. What you need to do is that in this position, see, there are hurdles that you will see. Now, when you have your weight here, this is the position which you need to attain. Okay. Possible that a lot of people will not be able to reach out till this position. So just be here. Just try to get here, okay? Only when you are comfortable in this position, only when you can shift your weight more to your hands, that is where you will actually attempt leaving one leg and then the other and then both the legs, okay? Not before that. Don't try to immediately get onto the position. It will require a lot of practice. And right now, what you are doing is doing a step-by-step practice, okay? So let's say have your weight completely on the hands, firm, come onto the legs, shift your body weight, and then slowly up and down. Shift your body weight. Start with one leg, then the other, and then try to do it with both the legs. Ashwini, if you increase the distance between both the hands, it will be a little more easier. Increase the distance a little bit from both the hands. Increase your base of support, okay? Your base of support has to be wide. If your base of support is short, you will find less place to keep your hands firm. Good, Nimesh sir. Doing well. Awesome. Good. Superb. Okay. So guys, I want you to practice this. This will also be done in our regular sessions. Okay. And now let's move on to a little bit of stretching exercises. I hope you all are not tired. And this is mandatory. You need to follow up with stretching. You have to make yourself flexible. And flexibility is not just with your upper body or lower body. Whatever poses that I'm showing you, don't just do it for Saturdays only when you meet me. You have to also practice this a little bit. If you are looking to achieve changes in your body. If you're looking to see some visually very, very different and, you know, looking at a lean body, only then you have to put in that extra effort. Okay. So let's start with a stretching session now. So this is what you're supposed to do. Maybe you will need a chair for this, or you can take support of a table or something. Okay. Just at what you can say, all you have to do is, so let me just adjust the camera and show it for you. Yeah. Get hold of a sofa and you will be on your knees like this. Okay. On your knees, your hands are absolutely straight and firm towards the table or the sofa, which will be at shoulder level once you are at your knees. And then what you're supposed to do is look down and keep this stretch firm. Maintain this position. I want you to maintain this position for about a minute. I want you to first take the position, only then I will start checking on the time. Can you make yourself comfortable and get that position first? Make sure you adjust your camera so that I can see you. So basically, your knees and your pelvis is in the same line, okay? And the rest of the body is shifting forward. All right? Get hold of a table or a chair or even your sofa where you can rest your hands completely. Your hands will be resting straight, okay? It is just resting like this. So straight, everything is absolutely straight so that you can feel the stretch. Right. Now, can we start the time? Your time starts now. Keep your pelvis down. Keep your shoulders down. Keep your wrist in neutral position. You will start feeling a lot of stretch around this whole area, this whole shoulder portion. Now, we are doing a lot of exercise with the shoulder. We are trying to strengthen our shoulder. So it's very important that there is a good amount of stretching that we need to do. Yes. You may need something on your knees in order to support your knees because you're being 30 seconds done.
Very good. Awesome.
Down, down, down. Come on. 30 seconds done. Good. 20 more seconds to go. Keep that position. Don't move. Awesome. Five more seconds to go. And relax. Okay. Can you feel the stretch? Now just move your shoulders a little bit. Now that you have stretched this completely, you can actually feel the stretch, right? Yeah. Okay. Comfortable? Was it difficult, easy, medium? What was it? Okay, we are going to do this once more. Come on, same position. Take the position, come on. We'll hold it for a minute. Make sure you're putting some support on your knees, okay? Don't let your knees just be on the floor because you will start feeling a pressure. So make sure your knees are on the mat. Yeah, your time starts now. Hands up.
Yes.
Very good. Nice. Pretty good. Pretty good. 15 seconds done. Good position. Good position, most of you. Very good. Thirty seconds done. Good. Awesome. Good position, Anupam. Fifteen more seconds to go. Good position, Sunil. Nice. That's how you feel the stretch. Very good. Good one, Kiran. Good, Himanshu. Good one, Poonam. Okay, done. Awesome. Awesome. Okay. Do you feel a little difficult to move your hands after this stretch? Do you find it very... Have you been able to stretch, feel this kind of, experience this kind of stretch before? Okay. Moving on to the next stretch. I want you to be on the mat. Yep. So you can actually, we just need half of the mat, okay? Now, what you need to do is that keep your hands backward, like this, in this position, both hands, okay? It's as if you're putting all your weight on your hands, okay? This is the position that you need with your elbows straight, okay? Now, what I want you to do is that take your feet a little ahead and then your pelvis and keep your hands at the same position. This is the stretch that we need to do. Initially, you stretched your plexus. Now, you're stretching your extensors. So, shift the pelvis forward. Keep the shoulders firm there and shift the pelvis forward. You will start feeling a stretch. Yes. Have you been able to get the position? Come on. Hands, weight on your hands, firm, and then move your pelvis like this. Okay. So your elbow is absolutely straight, right? And then you shift your pelvis forward, whatever extent you can. And then let's start the time. Have you been all in this position? Your time starts now. Yes. Let's take this position. Come on. Good. And don't take your pelvis back. Okay. Make sure your weight is firm on your hands. Pelvis ahead. It is resting. Your pelvis is resting. Okay. You don't have to keep it in the air. It is absolutely resting. Our focus here is only on the shoulders. Right. Good. 30 seconds done. Come on. Nice. Very good. Keep shifting your pelvis forward. If you feel there is a room for stretch, try to shift it a little more forward. Okay. It's okay to improve your stretch gradually. 45 seconds done. Follow the time. Do not leave the position. 1 minute. Relax. Comfortable? Is that all good? Right. See, you will feel a little bit of soreness today after the session. So I will suggest you to do some icing to that area wherever you feel soreness. But yes, whatever we are doing is not easy. It's not some basic stuff, okay? You're doing something which is something really different and a little difficult, yes. Okay, can we move on to the next stretch? Right, now we'll have some stretches for the lower limb, okay? That is the lower body. Now, what I want you to do is keep your knees straight, firm, upper body straight, and reach out to your toes, okay? Preferably, I want you to reach out to the lower area of the toe. It's not exactly the toe, but more on the heel area. Okay. Now, if you're able to touch it, start bending your elbows and coming closer like this. If you're not able to touch it, just look at reaching out. If you find difficult, grossly touching it, use a towel or something which you can place it around this area and reach out this way. Okay. So let's try and do this. I'll check the time for you. Okay. Is everybody in the position now? Firm. Hold it here. Okay. If you can bend your elbow, great. If you cannot bend your elbow, just try to keep reaching it out. Maybe even if you're trying to reach out to the toes, it is good enough. Okay. Let's start. Your time starts now. We'll hold this position for 1 minute. Come on. Let's do it. Do not try to bend your knee and reach out to the toes. What we need is the knees are straight, because only when the knees are straight, you can feel the stretch on the hamstrings. Okay. It's okay if you're not able to reach it at this point of time. It's okay if you can just touch onto the edge of the toes, but do not bend your knees. Bending your knees is like a compensation. If you compensate right now, you will never be able to stretch this, do this stretch properly next time. Okay.
45
seconds done. 15 more seconds to go. Elbows bend. If you can try to bend your elbows, that's great. Like this. And relax. Comfortable? How was it? Could you feel a good stretch? Right. Okay. Don't ever miss stretching sessions. Even when you're done with the whole session, don't ever miss the stretching session, because this is what will decide and improve your recovery. Okay. Next stretch. Okay. Now, what you're supposed to do is that increase the distance between your legs as much as possible. Legs wide apart. Hands are straight. Touch it to the floor. Try and touch your hands to the floor and then slowly start sliding it forward to whatever extent you can. Okay? Can you all do that? Can you take that position? Distance between the legs.
Come on.
Yes. Hands
forward.
I want you to hold this position for a minute. Okay? Your time starts now. Shriyang, are you doing it? Oh, yeah. Good, good, good. Come on. Hands forward. It is absolutely okay if you cannot even touch your hands on the floor. Understand one thing, probably you have a little bit of tight hip muscles, so it's absolutely fine, but it's a matter of practice. The more you practice, you will get. So take it ahead. Yes. After 30 seconds, you may feel that you are able to reach out a little more, okay? Because your hip muscles will open up a bit, which is a good sign. So then that's the time where you can reach a little more forward. Okay. 40 seconds done. Good, good.
Very good.
Five more seconds to go. You need to keep your breathing in control. A lot of time we want to get out of any stretching pose is because we don't understand the breathing pattern. So just keep your breathing in control. If your breathing is in control, you'll be able to achieve that.
Relax.
Nice. We'll do that once more. Okay. So legs
way apart.
Hands forward. Keep sliding as much as possible. Keep sliding it. Your time starts now. Keep sliding. After 15 to 30 seconds, you may feel that the hip is opening up a bit, which is good. So then you can take it a little more forward. Five seconds done. Good. Awesome. Okay, relax. Good enough. Legs closed. Comfortable?
Doctor, one question.
Yes.
Yeah. When we are stretching, should our hands be
fingers?
Should they be closer to each other or should they be apart?
This distance.
This distance.
Shoulder width. You know, you just have to keep following the shoulder width and keep moving like this forward.
Okay.
You don't have to be close.
See, yeah, this is Ravindra here. If you can see
yes,
me.
Yes, I can.
I've got a little stretch here in this portion.
Scapula, yes, it is bound to happen. So what you can do is just stretch this portion like this a bit and feel that relax. Because, you know, if you have a little bit of tightness around the scapular portion, it is possible that when you reach out this way, you will find it difficult. So just stretch it like this on both sides. Move around a little bit.
Yeah, yes. So what I was doing was possibly right. That is why it happened.
Yep. Absolutely.
Nothing wrong.
Okay.
Clear.
So this is about the stretches.
Yeah, doctor, this is one stretch which I am not even forget about stretching. I can't even be in normal state, 90 degree as well. Yes. So it happens. Like so, would it be okay if I tie a rope and try to pull myself somewhere?
Yes, you can. You can do that, or you can probably try to reach out that way. Okay.
Okay.
You can try to reach out that way. Yes. See, it just needs a initial bending in the beginning. Okay. If you have that, eventually you will be reaching out to the floor. You can actually get your head down to the floor, and it will happen.
But yes,
it needs a lot of practice. You have to see. This is a 1 minute stretch, and ideally, you should be practicing this every day at least twice. At least you should be able to do this twice. Okay. And by the way, for all the people who have been able to achieve your crow pose, I need a photograph. For LSIT, I need a photograph from all of you. Okay. Because you know what? When you keep posting these photographs, this is actually a check for us. It's like 15 days now. I know some people posted their photos in the last session, and that was really great. And a lot of people missed it. So let's see if you have been able to do it. Please keep posting your photographs. That will be awesome. And it will be a check for us to understand how well are you doing? Where is your difficulty? And how well are you improving? Like, you know, after 15 days, again, when we take these photographs, we'll see a lot of difference. So the next session, we'll be trying to do a headstand. Okay. So make sure you get yourself flexible. We'll be doing it with the support. Don't worry. We'll be doing it with the wall support. I will not immediately take you just without support. So we'll be doing it with the wall support. But yes, we will be attempting that. Okay. Any questions from any of you? Any questions? How are you finding these sessions? I need some feedback from you all. Do you see any difference for all the people who have done these sessions last time and this time? What is it that you find different in your fitness protocol?
In the last session, I was not able to do the crow pose, but today I was able to do it for at least 4 to 5 seconds.
Great. That is superb. That is superb. So I need your photograph, Narottam. Try again and send your photograph. Yes.
Okay.
Yes. What else? Who all have seen the difference? So it's going to take... Yes, Chandrakant. Yes.
Yeah. I mean, what we used to do earlier 20, 25 times, you know, that used to be very easy. But this knee push-up, even 10 times, quite a difficult one.
Exactly. So the idea is to engage a lot more muscles. Okay. Change the pattern. You know, let's say when you were doing these regular workouts, you were doing 25 push-ups at one go, but your hands were way apart. Your weight was more on the toes. So it was a little easy. Okay. Now what we are doing is we are trying to engage your core a lot more. We are trying to make it more effective toward the shoulder and scapular area. And we are definitely using a different group of muscles which needs to fire. Now, once this starts happening, you will find it difficult in the beginning. No doubt about that. And I'm not even saying that you'll be able to do 100 push-ups of planche push-up eventually. No, we will stick to probably just 25 to 30 push-ups. But the intensity and the firing is much more. So that is the difference what we are trying to get in through these workouts. And I don't want to make this change dramatically. That's the reason I'm going slow. That's the reason I'm just doing one session in 15 days. But yes, for all those people who are looking to create a difference in your body, you need to incorporate all of this when you're doing these regular online workouts also. Okay. So for example, if your trainer tells you to do push-ups, try to attempt planche push-ups instead of normal push-ups. Okay. So this is how you will be able to contribute. After every session that you are done, try to do a crow pose. Try to keep checking yourself. It doesn't take a lot of time. Since you're already warmed up, it won't take a lot of time for you to get into that position. It is basically like a check as to how are you doing in terms of your contraction, in terms of your firing, and in terms of your support for your upper body or your lower body, right? So I hope this session is helpful for you all and for all the beginners and for all the people who have joined. And in fact, there will be a little bit of soreness here and there because it's not going to be easy. So stretch yourself and do some icing to recover. That's all what you're supposed to do. Any questions? Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much for joining in. Thank you.
Yeah, doctor, if you could stay back for a minute. Ravindra here.
Yes.
Sure. Definitely.
Thank you, doc.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.
Oh, no, change it.